Organization.
As Kashmir still fights the worst floods in 60 years, about 4 lakh people are stranded and desperate for help across the state. Our reporters spread across Jammu and Kashmir bring you these dispatches, stories of survivors and the brave effort of the army.
I'm at the worst affected area of Srinagar. This behind me is the Jawaharnagar Kursu Rajbagh area, and as you can see, it's completely waterlogged. This is the scene in most of surrounding areas. The water level is still, it's not receding. It's still almost the second and third floors have been covered, and there are still thousands of people inside who are trapped. Kids, elderly, patients, everyone is stranded there. And in fact, there is right now at this place, there is no help from the army. There is no civil administration, and whatever help is coming in is coming from local people who have made crude boats just to go inside and ferry people. There are such things that are happening all across this Bhand area, this embankment of the Jhelum River on this side of South Srinagar. As you can see behind me, this is the scene, and right now, although the choppers have been pressed into service, but they are getting out only a few people because the magnitude is very big. There are thousands of people who are still trapped inside. There are, as I said, children, there are elderly, there are patients who are trapped inside and need immediate help. Now, what these people are saying is that they need boats. There are very less boats. And in fact, as I said, they have made crude boats. They have made boats out of things that really are right now available with them. They need boats, and they need hundreds of boats right now to go into this area, because every passing minute people are losing hope. There are people who are in desperate need of medicines, of there are ill people inside, so they immediately need help. So they need more boats right now. That is the SOS from this particular area. And in fact, right now there are rescue operations that are happening across the Srinagar city, but this is the worst affected area. The height of this water is around 15 to 20 feet, so you can imagine complete houses have gone underneath the water. So this is the worst affected area, but right now more boats required, medicines required, and food required for these people, rescue required, because other than that, these people, locals are handling, they are bringing in relief, but rescue is right now which is the priority.
खाने के लिए तो कुछ नहीं है, तो पानी पीने के लिए तो कुछ है नहीं. बच्चे हैं अभी घर में, घरों में बोटें इतनी हैं नहीं जो उन बंदों को निकाल सके वहाँ पे. वो तो आवाज़ें मारते हैं मगर वहाँ पे बोट्स हैं नहीं जो उनको निकाल सके वहाँ पर. बाकी देखे जो डैमेज मेरे सामने, जो सुबह की आज सुबह की न्यूज़ है, 9 मकान मेरे सामने डैमेज हुए थे जिसमें 23 बंदे थे
जी.
उसमें से सिर्फ 4 बाहर निकले हुए हैं, वो भी अपनी हिम्मत से. बाकी मकान के नीचे ही हैं सारे.
गवर्नमेंट का कोई अता पता नहीं है कि गवर्नमेंट है कि नहीं. हमें इस टाइम खाली बोटों की ज़रूरत है, लोगों को बचाने की ज़रूरत है. यहाँ के जो लोकल पीपल है, उन्होंने टूर्स में निकाल के उनको निकाला है. 2 दिन के बाद अब आई है एयरफोर्स की टीम, आर्मी की टीम, वो इनको निकाल रही है. बाकी हमने तो खुद ही काम किया, यहाँ के जो लोकल से उनने काम किया. गवर्नमेंट ने 10 दिन पहले,
अभी तक कितने लोगों बचे और कहाँ कहाँ फंसे हैं लोग?
अभी हमने हमारे जो टीम है 200 लड़के हमारे अपने वॉलंटियर से यहाँ पे, उन्होंने कम से कम 4,000 लोगों को बचाया अब तक.
टाइम्स का कॉरेस्पॉन्डेंट पद्मजा सेंड्स दिस डिस्पैच फ्रॉम फ्लड रैविज्ड एरियाज इन रामबाग, स्पीकिंग टू सर्वाइवर्स हू हैव क्वेश्चन्ड द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स एफर्ट्स.
Right behind me is the Rambagh area, which still remains completely inundated, and tempers are running extremely high even as the NDRF is trying to launch as many rescue operations as possible. But one can understand that the lifeboats are in short supply. At one time, only about 10 people can be accommodated in these lifeboats. So the NDRF is carrying out one sortie in every few minutes. But even then, the people who are waiting on the sides are worried about the safety of their families. They are wondering why their families haven't been brought back yet, and their patience is running very thin and tempers are flying.
किसी का कोई जान पहचान वाला है उसको ये बोट प्रोवाइड करते हैं. ऐसे हम सुबह 3-4 घंटे से यहाँ खड़े हुए हैं, कुछ नहीं हो रहा है. पूछ रहे हैं कि कोई जान पहचान वाला है तो तभी आपको बोट मिलेगा. कैसे मिलेगा बोट? हमारे 46 आदमी है, हमारे घर के जो सदस्य हैं, जवाहर नगर में एक मकान में फंसे हुए हैं. मकान दिस रहा है कल से वो कल.
लेकिन अभी जैसे बोट आई भी है, थोड़ा टाइम लगेगा इवैक्यूएशन.
सुबह से आज 8 दिन से 4-5 दिन हो गया ब्लड हुआ, आज बोट अगर आए हुए हैं. ये क्या गवर्नमेंट की पॉलिसी है? आज भेजने आप 6 दिन से फंसे हुए लोग, सारा कश्मीर जल रहा है, सिटी के ऐसे एरियो में, मैं विक्रम सिंह बोल रहा हूँ, सिटी के ऐसे एरियाज में फ्लड हुआ है जहाँ पे कभी आया नहीं है, इनको पता नहीं है कैसा करना है, आज ये भेजने, ये फेलियर है, टोटली फेलियर है।
हम नटीपुरा में थे, आज हमें 3-4 दिन हो गए, वहाँ पे कोई मतलब कोई नहीं आया वहाँ पे, तो फिर मेरे हस्बैंड ये पुलिस में थे, तो उन्होंने वो लाया बोर्ड जैसा, तो हम उसमें आए, तो फिर आगे हम पहुँचे, फिर वहाँ से हमें उन्होंने किश्ती में लाया।
और खाने पीने का आप आगे
क्या? खाने पीने का जो हमें सामान थोड़ा बहुत था, हमें वही, कुछ भी नहीं, टोटल नहीं, वहाँ पे कोई ये नहीं है बंदोबस्त, कुछ भी नहीं।
कहाँ से लेके आए?
रामबाग से।
आप कहाँ थे, मतलब बिल्डिंग पे ऊपर थे?
रामबाग अपनी बिल्डिंग से निकलकर दूसरे की बिल्डिंग में थे, मगर वहाँ भी एक मंजिल तक पानी है।
कितने दिन से?
वहाँ से 2 दिन से।
तो कौन थे आपके साथ?
ये मेरा पिताजी है। हाँ,
तो कैसे आप निकल के आए?
बोट से, बोट वालों ने निकाला। बोट वालों ने निकाला।
अभी वहाँ और भी लोग हैं क्या?
अभी और भी बहुत सारे लोग हैं, और वो बाएं साइड में जो है उस वहाँ पर ज्यादा पानी है। हाँ। वहाँ ज्यादा लोग है, वहाँ बोट नहीं जाती है,
नहीं जा रही,
वो बोट नहीं,
लोग हैं वहाँ पे अभी,
लोग बहुत है मगर वहाँ बोट नहीं जा सकती है, पानी ज्यादा आ रहा है वहाँ से।
हाँ।
बोट वालों ने कोशिश की मगर उनकी बोट नहीं जा रही है।
Right behind me is the Rambagh area, which still remains completely inundated, and tempers are running extremely high even as the NDRF is trying to launch as many rescue operations as possible.
Watch detailed coverage on Times Now.
Times Now is helping people reach out to their friends and family. If you have a message, we will broadcast it.
Kids, my both the children, Ishan Mangal, Khushboo Mangal, my parents, Purushottam Agarwal, Kumkum Agarwal, and my elder uncle and auntie, Ramratan Agarwal and Kailash Agarwal. So they all are stuck there, and there's no contact with them since Sunday evening. And Sunday evening, yeah, and we are trying our level best to communicate with them. The helpline numbers are of no use. It's giving the message that the lines are busy, not reachable, and I just hope that they are safe, because my son, he is asthmatic, and last when I spoke to him, he said ke mama, I want to come back, mujhe pani se bahut dar lagta hai, you please save me, I don't want to be here, I want to come back again.
As the flood situation continues to remain grim in the valley, our correspondent Pooja Shali reports from a memorial hall in Rawalpura that has been converted into a shelter home.
These are several women who've been rescued either by their own relatives, from the forces, by other people. They have now come together at a marriage hall here, community center, converted into a shelter, because they are in fact survivors and who now are trying to help other people who are constantly pouring in. I have been meeting them. These specific women are from areas like Batmalu and other areas. This is Rawalpura, which has not been much affected. And finally, let me tell you, they are specifically trying to help other people and try and provide food, which has now been donated personally by people, locals here in Srinagar. With Imtiaz, Josh Holly for Times Now.
A lot of people are still clinging on to the rooftop. They are hoping for the best. They are hungry. They are waiting for food packages. The helicopter is all they have.
Watch detailed coverage on Times Now.
I'm right now on board an ALH Advanced Light Helicopter, the Dhruv of the Indian Army, the Army Aviation Corps, and right now we are hovering over the area of Poonch to assess the damage sustained by this area due to the flood. And let me tell you, so far we've seen extensive damage done to roads, other structures, bridges, etc. Just now there was a bridge that we saw, that was, a portion of it was washed off, because of which the Poonch area is completely cut off, and the Indian Army is trying to restore this bridge. There are other areas as well in Rajouri that have suffered extensive damage, and on this chopper there is a special para commando of the Indian Army. This specially trained commando is on board this chopper, so that just in case there's a distress call from anywhere where there are stranded people need to be evacuated immediately, this chopper responds to that call, and with the help of winching machine, this commando is lowered to the people in distress, and those people are evacuated immediately wherever such need arises. Right now we are over the area of Poonch. This area is completely cut off as of now from the rest of the state of Jammu and Kashmir, and the essential supplies are only replenished by way of these helicopters, the helicopters of the Indian Army as well as the Indian Air Force. Yesterday we also went to Riyasi area in Mahar, where we saw the Indian Army was sending essential supplies to the people who were struck there. Indian Army is also using its advanced light helicopters to reach out to those people in distress, in need. And by using these helicopters, the Indian Army had also rescued some BSF people who were struck on their post, which had come under the area, which was extensively flooded. And by using these choppers, as well as these highly trained men, these para commandos, at least four of the BSF men were evacuated from that area that was right on the line of control in Poonch area itself. And right now we are landing in Poonch on this military helipad, and we are going to further see the kind of damage that has been sustained by the area, the infrastructure, and how the Indian Army is trying to restore those devastated areas, and how the Indian Army is doing its best in restoring the connectivity to these very crucial areas.
The heavy rains started with effect from third morning, and third, fourth, fifth, the rains continued, and all the water bodies in the Poonch district, they were overflowing with the water touching to about 10 feet of this level, and as a result there was extensive damage to the property of the civilian people, the houses, worth about 110 houses in the Poonch town itself stands damaged, 60 totally damaged and 50 partially damaged. The bridges, three important bridges to the Poonch town, that is the Drungli Nala, where we are standing now, the Shere Kashmir, the main connectivity, and the TDR Nala, which is connecting the trade center. All three bridges stands damaged presently. The people have suffered badly. There are worth about 1,500 people who have been displaced from their houses. This is all the damage going on.
And any casualty figure that you have of the area, sir?
So far, the figures what we have got is 21 civilian people dead with 4 missing, and there is no power supply to the town, there is no water supply to the town, and apart from that, worth about 186 local animals dead, worth about 80 vehicles washed away. This is what the specific.
So, what is the Army's role in alleviating this problem as far as this trouble of the people is concerned?
See, for the first 3 days, our focus was to save the lives of the people because they were struck at all the places. So a lot of relief columns were launched, and we rescued the people from all the places wherever they were struck in the water channels or the areas which were getting totally flooded. And along with that, immediately after that, our focus was on the medical assistance for all the people who were rescued. So we established the medical camps. Then this area being a local people, to them the animals are very important. So we immediately also provided them the vet medical assistance to ensure that the animals, the death of the animals can be saved. And thereafter, now our focus totally is on to the rehabilitation and the restoration of the connectivity which the Poonch town is suffering badly.
Work is going on at bar footing pace to reconstruct and repair this Jammu-Srinagar National Highway near Ramsu, which has been washed away by the landslides 2 days back.
As floods devastate the state, the 300-kilometer-long Jammu-Srinagar National Highway remains closed for the sixth day today. Pradeep Datta with this latest dispatch.
Work is going on at bar footing pace to reconstruct and repair this Jammu-Srinagar National Highway near Ramsu, which has been washed away by the landslides 2 days back. They are trying to restore this road connectivity that connects Kashmir with the rest of the world. You can see that heavy machinery like JCB and L&Ts have been pressed into service. Several of these machines, they are trying to clear the debris. And besides this, they are also trying to break the rocky cavity so that once again they can restore this road connectivity. They are having a lot of challenges. Every day they are battling against all odds especially because of the shooting stones that come from the nearby mountains. Let us talk to the person here who is operating this machine and find out the trouble and dangers they are facing every day during this road clearance operation. Sir, आप हमें बताएंगे कि क्या किस्म की प्रॉब्लम और चैलेंजेस आपको आते हैं जब ये ज्यादातर रोड क्लियर करते हैं?
अभी इसमें कुछ बोल नहीं सकते हम लोग, अभी लगे हुए हैं, कोशिश कर रहे हैं, जितना जल्दी होगा तो अच्छा ही है।
शूटिंग स्टोन की वजह से कितनी प्रॉब्लम आती है और कैसे होता है?
बाकी जनता के लिए प्रॉब्लम है ही, ये बहुत ज्यादा है। जैसे ऑपरेटर काम करते हैं, ऊपर से पत्थर आ रहे हैं, तो कोशिश कर रहे हैं जितना अपनी अपनी सेफ्टी भी देखना जरूरी है।
Often their work gets hampered because of shooting stones that comes from the nearby mountains. So despite all these dangers, they are working day in and out 24/7 to see that this lifeline to Kashmir is restored. Because every day from this area, about hundreds of trucks cross and they carry with them ration, supplies, diesel and other service, not only for the civilians but also army personnel. They have brought with them also the rock breakers, because at several places it's a hard rocky cavity. They have to construct a culvert besides filling up this road, and it will take around about 2 to 3 more days. But these men are here facing all odds, all dangers, and they are trying to ensure that the people of Kashmir once again reconnected and they get the essential supplies to that area is restored, so that they are not to suffer for the medicine or ration at this point of time. Pradeep Datta reporting with Amit Bhardwaj from Jammu Srinagar National Highway for Times Now.
As Jammu and Kashmir battles the flood fury,
These are the people, those who are instrumental in carrying out such rescue operations, which are daring in nature, and it really takes guts of steel to carry out such operations. These are the men of the Army Aviation Corps, and some of them are special commandos, those who slither down that winching cable and pull out people in order to save every single soul that is in distress.
Watch detailed coverage on Times Now.
I'm right now standing on the Durangali Nala Bridge, which connects Poonch. This is one of the three bridges that connects Poonch with the rest of the state. But unfortunately, all three bridges lost connectivity. In fact, some parts of those bridges got washed away. This is the damaged part of this Durangali Nala Bridge, which is now being restored by the engineers of the Indian Army and the Border Roads Organization. This is the bridge that is being put in place here in order to restore connectivity, as Poonch is a very, very critical area as far as the operational needs of the Indian Army is concerned, and it is all the more critical, all the more crucial to keep the supply lines open as far as the Indian Army is concerned, and civilian population of course also needs those essential supplies. So in order to maintain that connectivity, re-establish the connectivity, the Corps of Engineers of the Indian Army as well as the Border Roads Organization are doing a marvelous job. This bridge has been put in place in just a couple of days. In fact, the work started 2 days ago, and the connectivity is already restored. But rebuilding, of course, will take time. There are two other bridges, Sher-e Kashmir Bridge and another one. They also have some of their portions washed away, and the work will commence there as well. But as far as similar damage to roads and bridges is concerned, it is extensive. The Chief Engineer of Border Roads Organization told us in his area of responsibility, which is around 3,000 odd kilometers, more than 1,000 kilometers of roads and bridges, they have suffered extensive damage, and it is going to take a lot of time to rebuild and re-establish those links. Although connectivity of course will be restored in a few days, in about a week or so, but several areas of Jammu and Kashmir, the far-flung areas such as Gul, etc., they still remain disconnected. The connectivity has not been restored to those areas, but of course the Indian Army as well as the Border Roads Organization sparing no effort, doing a marvelous job, and speed is also of essence in these kind of works, as you know, civilian population as well as the defense establishment need to keep these supply lines open, and keeping that in mind, the work is happening here at a tremendous pace. In Poonch, Shamsher Khan for Times Now. Sir, give us an idea as to what is happening here. You are trying to relay a bridge here.
What we are trying to do is restore connectivity, in the sense this bridge has got damaged. Now what we've just launched this bridge basically on a war footing. The reason was Poonch was totally cut off for last 4-5 days. Yesterday, although we restored the connectivity, this was a major thaw in our effort. So today with this bridge, which will be completed in about an hour and a half's time, Poonch will be connected with the rest of the world. But that
this
is only
course, connectivity. This is of course alternate connectivity because the main bridge leading to Poonch, it still remains cut off, right?
That's what you are absolutely right. Actually, we are now focusing on connectivity only. The main road itself is damaged in a large number of places, and there is a major formation reach of about a kilometer, just short of reaching the Shari Kashmir Bridge, and that will take some time because we have to cut a new formation on that bridge.
मेरे भाई और मेरी भाभी उनके साथ में एक कपल और है और साथ में एक 8 महीने का बच्चा है. वो सभी लोग फंसे हुए हैं वहाँ पर. मेरी लास्ट कल उनसे 10 बजे बात हुई थी मॉर्निंग में. आज 24 घंटे बीत गए, उनसे कोई बात नहीं हो पाई है. मैंने गवर्नमेंट द्वारा दिए गए नंबर पे भी संपर्क करना चाहा, उन पे नंबर पे कॉल लगा, घंटी गई, लेकिन किसी ने पिक नहीं किया. तो उसके बाद मैंने टाइम से संपर्क किया. वो वहाँ पर डल झील के वहाँ पर रुके हुए हैं, डल गेट मार्केट के वहाँ पर, जो कि होटल दमदम में रुके हुए हैं. और उनकी हालत वहाँ पे बहुत ख़राब है, क्योंकि उनसे पूरी बात तो हो नहीं पा रही, लेकिन हालत बहुत ख़राब है बिकॉज़ वहाँ पे सभी लोग जो है तीसरी मंजिल पे रुके हुए हैं, जितनी मेरी बात हो पाई है उनसे.
There are many of the tourists who had been trapped here in Kashmir Valley for the last so many days without food and water, and finally they had either managed to flee from the floods or they had been evacuated by the rescue teams there. Let's talk to them and find out the problems they had faced all these days. आप बताएंगे कितनी मुश्किलों का सामना करना पड़ा आप कितने दिन?
बहुत मुश्किल से आज बुधवार से हम लोग बैठे हैं यहाँ पहलगाम में हैं. पाँच हम लोग कभी ऐसा रास्ता नहीं चढ़े हैं. बहुत मुश्किल से आ रहे हैं. 16 जन हम लोग हैं. 16 जन कैसे कैसे आए. एक जन भी बिछड़ जाता था. आज हम लोग का माता रानी का बहुत कृपा है कि कैसे हम लोग को पहुंचा दी है. बहुत लोग हैं हमसे बुरे हाल में फंसे हुए, लेकिन हम लोग जैसे तैसे निकल गए. कोई जो आदमी है लोकल आदमी वही हम लोग को हेल्प कर रहे हैं और कोई नहीं. ये बंदा जो है ये हमको ऊपर पहाड़ से नीचे लाया है पकड़ पकड़ के. कोई नहीं हेल्प कर रहा है और कोई.
See, Bean has connected them. They are saying that more than administration, it is the locals who have been helping them. They have not only provided them food and shelter, but they are also helped them just getting down from this steep mountain slope which they had to take, as the road connectivity to Kashmir has totally been washed away because of the landslides triggered by the flash floods. So they are facing lot of problems. Once again, the Kashmiris have proved that they are the most hospitable people. Even in this difficult condition, they have tried to help out their people who had come from different parts of the states, and they had been suffering without food and water. Whatever money they had, all they had exhausted. But somehow now they are waiting for the bus so that they can be taken back to their respective places. The problem with them is that many of them do not have the money, so they want the government to at least provide them some kind of a transportation facility so that they can reach back their homes. But thank God, all of them had been saved. They were about 12 to 15 members, all of them had been. But what about many of the people who are still trapped there and submerged in water? Their near and dear ones are trying to get in touch with them, but because of no cellular phone connectivity, nobody is able to know about the well-being of their near and dear ones.